My name is Lindsay Partridge, and I didn't always have a relationship with my horses like this. I've been working with horses since I was about 7 years old, and my sister took me to a horse camp with her, and I had no idea that that would change my life. I used to be the type of person that thought and was taught that if we wanted our horses to do something, that we needed to add more pressure to get what we wanted, or if the horse wasn't going over the jump that we wanted them to, that I should use a crop to just spank them to get them over it. I was taught that if my horse was doing something wrong or that they weren't stopping, that I should just get a harsher bit and pull harder on the reins. I didn't know any better. We used to run our horses if they were too energetic, but we would chase them to the point that they would snort and that they would put their tails up in the air, and I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know any different. And then it all kind of changed one day when I couldn't get my horses on the trailer. I was like, well, why can I get my horses to do so many things, but I can't get them to go on the trailer? And that kind of changed my world of thinking, where I had to think, why was my horse saying no, instead of just assuming that I should just get after them and get aggressive. And there was a person that I met that was named Gary Convery. And his philosophy was that there were no bad horses. There were just people that didn't have the time or the patience to understand them. And here, as I'm out here, this is my brand new Mustang, who's only been out of the holding pens for just a couple weeks. And he's getting brave enough to come to me in this big open space and still can be jumpy. But I'm much more understanding about why he reacts the way he does, and I understand his movements and understand how I can interact with him based on the way my energy level is and whether or not I'm too assertive or not passively dominant or all of these other things that I had no idea. And it all started with that mentor, Gary Convery, who challenged my way of thinking. After meeting Gary and kind of exploring the answer to the question of why is my horse reacting the way they are and what are they thinking? What are they trying to tell me? It kind of took me down this path of becoming addicted to learning and figuring out how to understand ourselves and our horses and the language that connects us. I became a person that tried to do a lot more with less. I started taking away the tools, taking away the bits, taking away the spurs, taking away the crops, taking away the round pens, taking away the small confined spaces, and taking away the chasing and the intimidation, and instead just really trying to figure out what does the body movements mean of the horse, and what is it that I'm projecting with my body and my leadership, and how can we find a relationship together where it's not about force and intimidation, and instead it's about mutual respect and understanding. And it's not that I became to hate tools. I don't think that whips are bad or crops are bad or spurs are bad. I just think that now I understand more about what it means to use a tool for refinement or more precise communication instead of taking a tool and using it to just add more force to the horse. And through my training with horses, I really just want to show people that there's a different way, because when I was growing up and I was working with horses, there's a lot of times when I think back to how I used to interact with them, and I just didn't know. I didn't know what it looked like when a horse was scared, and I didn't know what it looked like when a horse was overwhelmed, and I didn't know that there was other options to help the horse understand that the idea of just adding more pressure to get what you want was not really the only option available, that there are other things that you can do, that you can clarify for your horse, that you can wait until they understand, that you can learn how to motivate a horse in a different way, and that there are actually faster training techniques out there that don't provoke dangerous responses, that don't provoke a horse to rear up or run away or bolt out or kick at you, that you can actually have a relationship that's safer and more connected and easier to do. And so we came up with the Harmony Horsemanship Program. And I'm so excited about Harmony Horsemanship. We call it the 8 to 80 program, because you can be 8 years old or you can be 80 years old and you can use it and it works, because it's not based on your ability to be quick and agile or be fierce and strong. It's about learning to understand horses and to understand ourselves and understand how that language connects us in between. There's a bunch of different Harmony horsemanship instructors now that have been certified all over North America. And I couldn't be more excited about the different programs that we've put together for you. I'm Lindsay Partridge, and I'm here to tell you that you can do more with less.